there still pain and hurt looking back at that World Cup final defeat in Belfast, or is it completely part of the spokes and Six Nations?
No, I think anyone that was involved in it, whether they were playing on the game, whether they were coaching, whether they had had some input to it, whether they had supported you through it, whether they were fans, will always have some hurt towards it, and it was bitterly disappointing. Everyone wants to win that World Cup and to come so close to it. It certainly, I don't think it will ever leave anyone who was involved in it. But I think there's two things that could have happened. We could have let it define us, so we could have come out of that, sort of let it knock us down and not be able to pick ourselves back up again. And actually, one half of a game doesn't make us a bad team, and we know we've got areas to improve on and make sure that we improve to know when we get to big occasions like that, actually we can get and play the full 80 minutes to get the results that we want. So I think it's driven a lot of people that have been involved. It's driven a lot of people to come back out, come back fighting, and to go, do you know what, I'm not ready to sort of let it get to me and sort of bring me down. And I think that's the people that have been involved, and the new guys that have come in have just added to that energy and vibrancy to go, do you know what, this is my first involvement in England, I want to make it successful. And their drive and passion has sort of lifted us with them to take us on, hopefully, to a new level and to keep pushing our performances higher. So we're in a new cycle that 4 years' time, hopefully we can be on the end of a different result.